Hi, and welcome to Chef Maxwell's Kitchen. We're here at the Farm Bureau where we're getting ready to play with some more good Virginia food. The Virginia Department of Agriculture has a Virginia Grown program which illustrates all the great products that Virginia grows that are wonderful, above average. Right. We're going to be doing spinach. I don't know whether you know this, but there are restaurants, famous restaurants all over the world that won't put spinach on their menu if they can't get Virginia spinach. Lou Chow's in New York is one of them. All right, so what we're going to do to start this out is we're going to start sauteing some onions. Right, we're going to let that saute nice and slow, all right, so they get nice and clear, but don't crisp up on us. And what we're going to make is Spanokopita, which is a special little appetizer. It's phyllo dough in triangles filled with spinach and cheese. It's just really delicious. All right, I'm going to bring a bowl out here, and I'm going to take some spinach. This is blanched, chopped, chopped spinach. Now, blanch means to cook, throw down in boiling water for a couple of minutes. Chopped means to take it out of the boiling water and put it into ice water, all right? And that stops the cooking process and gives us a nice, good green color. All right, now I'm going to add some feta cheese. I like feta cheese, so we're going to add a lot of that. Mash that around in here. You want the cheese to break up into small pieces so it goes all over the place. That one. And that's about ready. I'm going to take an egg and put that in a bowl and whisk that up. All right, now we're going to put a little bit of mint in here. Mint is very Greek, Middle Eastern. They use a lot of mint over there. And this is a very Greek kind of appetizer. You can make this in a larger pie and have it for lunch or for dinner. All right, we're going to add a little bit of salt. Right. A little bit of pepper. Right. Now, this is all mixed up good, and you see how easy this is. We're going to add our onions. Right. Now, we've got our spinach mix made. I added the egg that we'd cracked in there. I didn't want to add it too soon because the onions were too hot, and I didn't want the egg to cook ahead of time. I've got butter melted, and now I've got my phyllo dough. Now, this is the kind of box it comes in. It's a long, rectangular box. Want the sheets. You don't want the cups or any other configuration. You want phyllo dough sheets, and this is what they look like. Right? And I'm going to take and unroll it. So we take one sheet, all right, put it here, and we're going to brush it with butter. Right, nice. You don't want to be too generous with the butter. You want to get it all coated, but you don't want to sog out the dough. So just a nice little brush. Right. And we're going to have another sheet. Stuff is very delicate. Right, and we're brushing it with butter again. We're going to do at least three sheets. Right. And you could do a fourth or a fifth if you want, but we're just going to do the three sheets. Right now I'm going to cut this lengthwise into four or five strips. Now I'm going to take a spoonful of the mixture and put it down here in the corner, and we're going to fold this just like you would a flag. We're going to fold a corner over, then flip it up, fold it over, flip it up, and fold it over. So we get a nice little triangle of spinach. We're going to do the other three on this sheet. And here it is. And we're going to put these on a sheet pan. We're going to brush them with butter. And we're going to bake them at about 350 degrees for about 20 minutes. And they're going to be nice and golden brown. And as soon as they're ready, we're going to pull them out of the oven, and we'll show you what they look like. All right, we're back. These are done. They come out of the oven. You notice we put them on a piece of parchment, but you could just grease the pan. That would be fine. All right, and now we're going to set these out, all right, on a pan, on a plate, for presentation. All right. And they are delightful little appetizers. All right. And we're going to take a little bit of mint And we're going to decorate the pan with some mint. And whether you're playing Greek or playing European or playing Virginian, as long as you're using Virginian food, it's good stuff. We'll be back next time for another episode of Chef Maxwell's Kitchen. We'll see you then. This recipe and all the recipes we've had here at Chef Maxwell's Kitchen are available on Recipes from Chef Maxwell's Kitchen, 10 Years of Tasty Television. Our new cookbook is coming out very soon, so make sure you visit the website and check on that. For more delicious recipes using Virginia-grown fruits and vegetables, contact Lisa Lloyd at the Virginia Department of Agriculture, 1100 Bank Street, Richmond, Virginia, 23219.
Chef Maxwell's recipes are listed on the Virginia Farm Bureau website at www.vafb.com.